I'm a hip hop artist out of Baltimore City, and the thing that I'm doing is it's a workshop that Kim helped me create called Hip Hop and Healing. When I first started like getting into music and wanting to be a musician, and I always was about music with a message. And I wanted to, my whole purpose and goal was to raise the consciousness of the people. And I saw that hip hop had a powerful ability to do that, because it was the language of the generation. When you want to communicate a message to a people, you have to speak the language that they understand. So it was the language of my generation growing up and the generation coming up after me. I wanted to use it for something positive. My music was about the liberation of minds, the elevation of spirit for people. And so I used to work with kids, and like there were juveniles in the criminal justice system, kids that are in group homes and residential facilities. They had like behavioral issues, and I noticed that they were dealing with a lot of trauma. And so, but a lot of kids, they were very excited I was able to talk to them, because they found out somehow that I was a rapper, and they wanted to learn how to rap, so I would teach them different rhyme techniques. But while we were doing that, I noticed that the things they were speaking about, their content, was very self-reflective of things that they were going through in their life. So I noticed that through creative writing and through putting those things in the hip hop form, it really forced them to be able to see themselves on the page and deal with their issues by having them write about it and put it in the rhyme form, something that they like to do anyway. So it became like a form of art therapy, art education integration, and it really works. I'm not a psychotherapist or nothing like that. I've worked with plenty of them, but I know that it's a way for them to vent and to channel their negative emotions through writing, through music. I take them through a whole gamut of how to rhyme, how to set things up, even if they want to take it to a business aspect of websites, if they want to go far as being a musician or a poet. I wanted to use the art what I thought it was meant for. That's like to stimulate thought, to create other independent thinkers. There are a lot of people that walk around with, they have a lot of emotional trauma that they don't realize, or unchecked mental illnesses, especially you come from a place where I come from, like Baltimore City, or you come from DC. It's a lot of things that happen to you growing up, drugs, crime, things you see every day that you become desensitized to, but you don't realize how much you internalize it, how much it probably has an effect on your life. And so some of these kids, they will say things like, my parents didn't want me, that's why I'm in this facility, or it was just a way for them to get those things out and deal with those emotions, and it was a way for us to talk to them about it. So I like to use music for that. I always felt like, you know, I'm a conscious MC, I'm a conscious rapper, but after you see my video, or you watch or you listen to my music and you're entertained or you're inspired for a brief second, what can I do next? And what can I do more? And it's something that partnered with the Teaching Artist Institute with Kim Poole has helped me do. Like, I want to do more in the community and help out young people and like change the world that way. Because I understand the words are powerful, music is powerful, and the rhythm that we use is powerful as well. So that's what I do. Hip hop and healing.